we'll go for the uniform factor method. So I told there is a growth factor method is there. So under the growth factor method, so there is a way four methods. One is uniform factor method, average factor method, fractor method, and furnace method. So first method, what I'm going to explain is uniform growth factor method. Okay, first one is uniform growth factor method. So in this, it is basically whatever the growth factor method is there. So in that method, the based or in the present whatever the travel pattern that can be projected for the design years. So for the future, so for that certain expansion factor that what it is being used, the same thing it is being used in this uniform factor methods also. Okay, so here the whatever the uniform factor method, so this method that assumes on the growth rate for the whole area. So that is been valid for the predicting the future interzonal trips. Okay, from one zone to another zone, from one, now it is now it is the futural zone from the one zone to another zone. The interconnecting the zone, the interconnecting zone trips. For that, a single growth factor that is E, that has been shown. Whatever the main theory is there. The growth factor method, so that a single growth factor which is being used for an entire area. So in this under a study, a calculating by dividing the future number of the trips ends the way where it is can be expected in the survey area for the design year by the trips end in the base year. So there the future trips between the zone I and zone J, where TIG are then that can be very easily calculated by the uniform growth factor of the E to the base year trips between the zone I and zone J. So that can be represented by formula TIJ, capital TIJ is equal to small letter TIJ into E. So here the capital TIJ, so that is the future. That can be said as the design years and the number of the trips for the future from the zone I to zone J. So for this one, for small TIJ, where that is the based year, the number of the trips from the zone I to zone J. So that's about the small TIJ. Next is E. So E is the growth factor. So in this the growth factor E, so that is the where the sing that is a factor. So that is been calculated by dividing the future number of the trips in the survey for the designing the by to that of the design years by the trips and in the base year. One it will be taken in the expected survey area. So that's about the growth factor the growth factor E. So this is very simple method. So next let's we go for the calculation of this distribution for the trips along the various zone in the one to n number. So that is given in the OD matrix, that is origin distribution matrix. So where the expected trips of the respected will be taken into assumption. So for that, so what are the required number of the trips for the future? So that will be should be calculated with the calculating the growth factor E. So that's about the growth factor method. So problem on this, how to calculate the future number of the trips and the calculating the growth factor, I will take that one problem and I will solve it. So based on that, okay, so this is what the problem. See here, so this is the origin and the OD matrix that is given. This is origin, this is distributions. So our different origin to distribution in the OD matrix that has been given, the where here this future number of the trips which is being generated from the 1 to 3, so that is expected as 360, 1260 and 3120. It is being given. Okay, so it is a very important problem. So what you do is, so whatever the origin matrix it is given, you write it, then the TI and capital TI you write down. So see here, this is been TI, so this has been calculated by adding all this. So add all this and then you will get this value. Okay, so again, after getting this value and this value, it is 60 plus 100, it's 160 plus 200. So that is 360, 60 plus 100, 160 plus 200. So totally 360. Okay. So same way, 100 plus 20, 120 plus 300, 420. So it is here written as 420. So same way, 200, 300, 20. So 520. So all whatever the values here you got it, so add together, you summate it, so that is summation of TI is equal to 1300, you will get it. So this is what the base here. So it has been given number of the trips, so that is 360, 1260 and 3120. So that's what the value it has been given here. So all the values whatever it is there, you summate it, summation of TI is equal to 4740. So where the TI is in the above matrix, so that represents the raw total or the total number of the trips which has been generated in the three zones at present. Okay, where the capital TI, so this one, okay, this capital TI that represents the future trips which has been generated in the three zones. Okay, so one, this is the present trips, so this is the future number of the trips, so that is, so should be kept in the mind. So whatever the total trips which has been generated at the present is 1300, and the total trips generated in the design years is, and means in future, so that is 4740, thus giving. So next, thus we will find out the growth factor. Growth factor is equal to future number of the trips which is being generated, that is 4740 divided by 131300. So if you divide it, you will get it 3.646. okay, so this is what the growth factor you should need to find it. Okay, got it. So this is one important problem. So after finding this growth factor 3.646, then that has to be multiple to each values of this given matrix. Okay, OD matrix you have to multiple. So that is 3.646 multiple by, and that should be multiple with the 60. Okay, so 60 into 3.646. So whatever value is there, that should be written here. Okay, like that, this one, whatever the matrix inside the OD matrix, whatever the values are there, all you should be added together, and whatever the previous steps, whatever the small TI and capital TI was there, what you have done, same thing you have to do it. Okay, so same thing here, the altogether value you have to add it, or you have to get this value by multiplying the growth factor. After later that, whatever the value you got it, so add together, you will get small TI. Okay, small TI you will get it. So later, so this is the capital TI, so that is given in the question. So submit it, you will get this value. Okay, so there you have to stop it. It has, so see here, so whatever the it will be seen that even though the trips which has been generated distribution here the both the values remains same, the trips in the present and the future trips which is remain same. the total of, per the data which is given in the total trips which has been generated in the each zone is being it is been calculated. So there you have to left out the problem. So that's all about the problem of this problem.